Okay, in this video, I will be installing a Samlex 300 watt pure sine inverter, okay, 12 volt. The model number of this is a PST-300-12. The 12 signifies 12 volts. Okay, so this will be installed in my RV so that I can have clean power to charge things like a laptop, run a laptop off of, things with lithium batteries like my camcorder, cell phones, that kind of thing. It's going to give you the cleanest power possible when running off of batteries, okay? So I will show you guys how to hook something like this up, and I'm going to do some things to make it easy to access in my RV as well. Stay tuned. Okay, so I've got the inverter here, and I have purchased a, this is a Leviton 3.6 amp duplex USB charger. So this power outlet, it's got your two 120 volt outlets, and then it has two USB that both charge at a max of 3.6 amps, okay, so, which is nearly the top charging rate that you could possibly get right now, okay, so, that is going to get mounted over here, which I'll show you, and then a faceplate for that, because it actually doesn't come with it. This cost me, $28 Canadian at Home Depot, and the faceplate was like $1.25 or something like that. Okay, so the inverter, my plan is to put it in this cupboard, which is, let's see if I can show you guys here. So in my RV here, I have the converter charger and power center. I've actually pulled that out all underneath the, this is the fridge here, okay, so all underneath the fridge I have this little cabinet here where the stereo is. There's the existing charging center, they call it, which is a 12 volt plug with USB, two USBs there. They're low power output, they're actually quite poor, I would say. So they work for some devices, but not really for others. They're very slow charging. And then above it, we've got the TV, up there. So behind this is the bottom of the fridge and the top part here. And the bottom of the shelving unit, hopefully you can see that good, is actually going into where the converter is. And sorry about the light, but there's, I don't know if you can see over there, it's just bare wood back there. And all the wiring for everything is located under there. So this is the ideal installation spot for this small inverter. Generally, a large inverter needs to be placed as close to your batteries as possible. But this trailer has 6-gauge wire going from the converter to the battery, and it's about a, I would say a 15 foot run to get to the battery. So the inverter mounting location that I'm going to pick is going to be right like this. Okay, and the reason why I'm picking that spot, can't really hold it up there, but the reason why I'm picking that spot up there is because I can easily just put a hole right here and go right into where the converter is and just wire it right into the converter, the main power runs. So there's nice thick wire going all the way to the batteries. And then what I'm gonna do for the power, because I don't wanna always have to plug in my devices at the inverter, I'm gonna use, this is an 18 gauge computer AC cord for a like a PC, like a computer tower, okay, so one end is your thing for going into the power supply, the other end is a, you know, a grounded outlet. I'm gonna cut off the end or whatever length I need here, and I'm gonna be able to plug in this into the inverter. Okay, the other end I'm gonna wire into my thing here, my outlet, which I'm gonna put up here. Okay, I'm not sure if I'm gonna mount it like this or next to it like that, but it's gonna be up here somewhere, might be below it. Okay, anyway, it's gonna be somewhere in here that looks nice. So I'll be wiring it into that. So this black thick, this thing is rated for 10 amps of AC electricity, which this thing isn't nearly gonna be putting out that. It's only 300 watts output power, so I don't have to worry about the cord being overheated or anything. So what my plan is to run the power wire. I'll probably go up on this bottom shelf where you can't see it. This is quite low to the ground. Up here, I'll come up, and then what I want to do is get it up to here. Okay, so I'll try to film as much as I can to sort of show what I'm doing. These alligator clips on this inverter are obviously going to be chopped off. They're just on there right now, but I just had to make sure the thing was working, which it works. So I will. This cord provided is enough. It's enough thickness for what the inverter puts out, according to the manual. And I'm going to shorten it to the minimum possible distance that I need. Okay, here's a look at the power center, or the converter power slash charger slash power center. We've got the negative terminals are up here. Okay, this really thick one is the one that's going to the straight to the battery. This red one down here is the thick one that's going to the battery. I have one lug here that's unused, so that is where I'm going to run the power for the inverter into, right there. Okay, and the negative, my converter here is using only what looks like about a 10 gauge wire, maybe 8 gauge. So this lug looks like it will fit like a 4 gauge wire in it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put both into the one negative terminal there on that side. So that's going to give me direct power with the longest, or the largest wire leads that I could possibly do without running brand new cables all the way to the battery. And like I said, in a larger inverter install, like 1000 watts, 1500 watts, etc., you're going to want huge cable, like 2 gauge at least, and short distance to batteries, like hopefully 2 or 3 feet. Okay, so this is just a small inverter install that I'm doing. Before you go start doing anything electrical in your RV, unhook the electricity. So do not have any shore cord hooked up to electricity, and unhook your batteries. Okay, you don't want any live circuits. You're gonna cause sparks. You're gonna possibly blow fuses or damage something, so make sure there's no power. Verify it by turning on lights in your RV. Try and just have a look at things like the microwave. Is the light on the microwave? Just make sure there's no power. So I have the inverter mounted securely there, and I have positive negative wires there going through. Drilled a small hole enough for the wires to feed through. Still need to do the earth ground here. Okay, the power on off switch is easily accessible right here. So, and then there's the outlet out, which I haven't done that side yet. And then over here, just to show you how. Okay, I'll see if I can get a shot of, see, you can see wires coming out of there. Okay, and then going into, it's this one here. Okay, this one here. Okay, there's the wire coming from the inverter. It's going into the back of the power center behind this. And I have the negative up here, the black wire with the whites, which is negative. Okay, so I've got it, them both in that one terminal there. And then the positive is down here
with this positive one on the left side. So that's giving it,
you know, the cleanest, like, best connection possible that I can do here without a direct wire straight to the batteries. This is pretty much a direct wire to the battery, so that is how I have wired it. Now onto the 120 volt receptacle, which I've actually pulled out the radio here, so just to make things easier, because I'm going to adjust where this thing sort of is, and I'm going to put it up here, so we'll get to that next. Okay, I just want to show you guys how I'm going to wire this plug, because it will be hard to show you once I have it in the wall, I think. So what I've done is I've taken my power cable, I've cut the end off of it, like the end that would plug into the actual computer. So we've got this end still attached right here, okay? And this is very crude. I just wanted to show how it was hooked up. I'm going to have to probably shorten this wire so it'll be a lot cleaner. But all these plugs are going to be labeled in the back. I don't know if it can focus on that. But it does say on here, white, hot is black, okay, and earth ground, which is the one over there, okay? So that's how you're gonna wire it. Now, if you're unfamiliar with electricity, don't do something like this. I'm gonna stress that again. Just either get an electrician to do this part, or somebody that knows what they're doing. Okay, don't because you could have different color wires. You can test continuity on these and figure out what wires what. So there is ways to do that, but don't go doing this. You could get a shock, you know, especially if this is live and you start touching these things, you're gonna get shocked. Okay, so please be very careful if you're gonna try to attempt something like this. Let's catch up on what I've done. I attached the earth ground. Let me see that right there. So we've done that. I've gone earth ground to the chassis frame. We've got the cord plugged in. We have it fed up through here. I've just put it in the corner. This is just a shelf that's low and you don't even see it if you open the doors. And this is where it's going. My old charging center thing was here, which was pretty much worthless. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to utilize the 12 volt adapter out of it. I'm going to put it in a different location somewhere. So what's going to happen is, here's my outlet wired up. So, okay, wired it up as per the instructions on the back. Okay. Got white, hot, earth ground. So this is gonna go in here, but I'm gonna flip it over. Like that. I'm gonna actually put it in this way. Just because I think I like it that way best. Plus I can utilize this hole without cutting a bunch of more stuff. Okay, well here is the finished product of the inverter install. You can see I've got a battery cutoff switch in there right there as well now. I've done that, which is going to be in another video. And here's the radio put back in, so it's not a mess. And I've added 12 volt socket up here and a USB socket there as well. Those are just regular 12 volt sockets, so the inverter doesn't need to be on to run these. These are going to be high powered though. So for charging like tablets and stuff like that, high power devices, it's gonna be quicker off of that. I didn't do a video of the top things because I didn't wanna confuse people, it's just too much. So I just ended up putting those guys in, and then above my TV, which runs on 12 volt power, it was a 120 volt, but converted to 12 volt with a transformer box thing. So I actually made that 12 volts, and I put a 12 volt plug up here. Okay, before I would have it in the, I would actually always have to plug it in down here on the power center. So now I've got it plugged in the top. So I can utilize this for something else. That's a 12 volt socket there. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. Hope this video helps you.